clock is ticking, and within just 10 days, Glenn County officials must cut more than $1 million from their budget.
Action News reporter Brian Callahan joins us now from our Chico newsroom to show us how they plan to trim the fat and why it could dramatically affect the criminal justice system. Brian?
Alan, Kira, Glenn County supervisors must make some tough decisions in the coming days, but say they must make some hard cuts to keep the county financially afloat.
Essentially, all these moves are detrimental to the county.
Glenn County supervisors heard from 10 department heads Tuesday discussing budget cuts proposed by the ad hoc committee.
I don't see any other way other than shifting pain from one department to the other this year, only to have that pain be deferred perhaps to another year.
The proposed budget calls for a $100,000 cut to the district attorney's office, something DA Robert Holzapfel says would devastate the department.
Based on the projected cuts, taking the two investigators, one attorney, and one secretary, that's a 44% plus decrease in staff, which will decrease the ability of your district attorney's office to effectively prosecute crime in Lake County.
Sheriff Larry Jones has already instituted measures hoping to cut the $225,000 the committee has asked for.
Saturday was our first day of zero backfill for overtime. That meant one deputy sheriff covered Glenn County.
The county's chief probation officer told the supervisors the recommended cuts would make the department the state's lowest funded probation department per capita, behind only Sierra County, something the district attorney says is unacceptable.
When we look at the criminal justice system, we're talking about the essence of our society so that we can live happy lives, so we can be free from fear.
Supervisors say they don't want to make the cuts, but they have to make sure the numbers add up.
We don't have reserves, so if you don't cut it in one department, you've got to find another department to cut. And we've already had departments that have laid people off, so it's a math problem.
The finance department is being asked to cut more than $180,000. Director says if that cut is approved, they may have to switch to a monthly payroll system. Supervisors are scheduled to vote on the final budget next Wednesday. For Action News, I'm Brian Callahan.
All right, thank you, Brian. The CalVed Home Loan Office in Redding will be closing its doors next spring. The office on Churn Creek Road serves 13 North State communities. The Deputy Secretary for the California Department of Veterans Affairs says the Redding office only made 12 loans in the last year. He says all the services will now be available online, and a Sacramento agent will travel to the area for veterans who want to deal in person. Shasta County is leading the effort to make sure every veteran gets a proper burial. Action News reporter Elizabeth Gadley is live in the Redding Broadcast Center with more on a newly appointed position that will focus on doing just that. Elizabeth.
Kira, this morning, Shasta County supervisors appointed the state's first Veterans Remains Officer to help find and bury forgotten veterans. It's part of the Missing in America project, which finds the unclaimed remains of veterans and honors them with a full military service. The remains are often found on mortuary shelves in cans or boxes, sometimes decades after the veteran died.
People, some of them died in battle, some of them died years afterwards, but we owe that to our veterans to give them a final tribute and a farewell. And we've found that there's thousands of cases where that hasn't been done.
On August 27th, the governor signed legislation requiring all California counties to appoint a Veterans Remains Officer. The Missing in America project started in Shasta County by resident Fred Salanti. Live in Redding at the Mount Shasta Mall, I'm Elizabeth Gadley for Action News.
Thank you, Elizabeth. A Butte County father is making good on a promise he made to his oldest daughter on the anniversary of her funeral. She was killed by a drunk driver 6 years ago. Action News reporter Linda Watkins-Bennett joins us now with a story. Linda?
Alan, time hasn't slowed Daryl Spessard's resolve to make a difference as he continues his campaign to prevent other families from experiencing the same tragedy.
Daryl Spessard's 24-year-old daughter, Andrea, was killed in a head-on crash on Highway 99 caused by a 17-year-old drunk driver. Saturday marked the sixth anniversary of her death. Spessard still brings fresh flowers to Andrea's memorial at Glen Oak Cemetery, renewing his pledge that he made the day she was laid to rest.
I promised to do whatever I could to try to make a difference, but also try to protect and save other lives, because I didn't want anyone else to ever experience or feel what we were going through as a family.
Spessard has made dozens of presentations working with law enforcement and schools, sharing Andrea's story. He reaches out to new victims as well, and even connected with the young man who killed his daughter upon his release from a youth facility, recruiting him to help.
But I do want people to understand that very easily could be them. And they're always one phone call away, just like we were.
Alcohol problems cost America $176 billion a year. Untreated alcohol problems are blamed for more than 100,000 deaths annually. Alcohol is the drug most used by 12 to 17-year-olds, fueling a growing price tag on underage drinking problems as well. Despite all this, Spessard vows to continue his work. He recently accepted an offer to work with the CHP on a presentation for Beale Air Force Base. He's grateful for every opportunity.
Is one of the ways that has helped me get through this ordeal. If I can help somebody else, I'd like to know. But most important is thank you for allowing me to keep the promise to Andrea.
Spessard wants to remind everyone there is a new Start Smart class tomorrow night at 6 o'clock at the Butte County Search and Rescue Building in Chico. It's offered through the CHP to teenage drivers, and there is still space available. For NBC 24 Action News, I'm Linda Watkins-Bennett.
Thank you for that, Linda. A Reading-based company is named one of the fastest-growing companies in the U.S. for a second year in a row. Computer repair company Nerds on Call made it on the Inc. 5000 list as one of the nation's fastest-growing private companies. Despite the recession, Nerds on Call saw 100% growth from 2006 to 2009. The company's founder says he never expected his business to boom the way it has.
We are very surprised. Like I said, when we first started, it was just a small ad in the newspaper. We were running it out of the house, and we had all the phone calls go to my wife's cell phone. And the idea was we were just going to be small, and we just needed money to pay the mortgage. And then it just exploded, and it's just never stopped.
Well, Nerds on Call now has offices throughout California, Oregon, and Washington. The company just opened a new storefront in Redding next to Target, where people can drop off their computers. For more information, go to our website and click on News Links.
More than 1,000 Shasta County middle school students got their first taste of college today. It's all part of the College Awareness and Career Day at Shasta College. Over the next 2 days, 1,300 area 8th graders are touring the campus to explore college classes and programs. The goal is to help middle school students realize that college is an option for everyone.
It helps create a college-going culture. Our rate of college-going could be better in this region, and Shasta College is a great place to start.
The event features a variety of presentations and a bus tour of campus. More than 17,000 eighth graders have visited Shasta College in the 11 years that this event has taken place.
An Action News update now on a young horse being nursed back to health by a Shingletown woman. Honey Bandit is on the mend. The foal was one of the wild horses being relocated in a federal roundup. The horse was near death when the Shingletown resident, Palomino Armstrong, rescued it from the Bureau of Land Management Adoption Facility. BLM officials made a handshake agreement to put 1,000 wild horses on a million-acre private horse sanctuary in Nevada, and if all works out, all 36,000 horses could end up at that sanctuary.
Lawmakers and victims' families gathered in Washington, D.C. today for a summit on distracted driving and its sometimes deadly consequences.
We'll take an in-depth look at the problem and what's being done to keep you safe next on Action News.
And hot weather ahead, despite the clouds that we've got going on right now. We'll talk about it all and sort it all out for you when NBC 24 Action News returns.